at ShadowACS again. I'm just gonna come right out and say this. I enjoyed the dubbed version of D.N.Angel. I did. I really didn't mind the English version that much. Yeah, I know the English voice acting in this anime is terrible, and it does get hated on for good reason. But I didn't think it was so awful that I still couldn't enjoy the anime. Besides, it's got Vic Mignogna voicing a badass Phantom Thief. That should at least count for something. Anyway, D.N.Angel. This is one of those anime that seems to constantly skate the line between popular and obscure. Most people who have seen this anime really love it, and I'm no exception. Okay, it's no masterpiece, but it's a really fun and engaging action anime with some really memorable and likable characters. One thing in particular that I really like about D.N.Angel is that it's one of the only gothic shonen anime. I found that most shonens have this really lighthearted and campy tone to them. And that's fine, but it's still nice to see one that does something different. And even if the story of D.N.Angel isn't super adult, the designs still give it a really dark and edgy feel that I really enjoy. And speaking of the story, let's talk about it. Our main character is Daisuke Niwa, a pretty normal teenage boy, except for the fact that his mom and grandpa are occult freaks who try to train him in ninjutsu. Or whatever martial art requires them to put pitfall traps in their front hallway. But despite his crazy-ass family situation, Daisuke's only current goal is to get close to his crush, a girl named Risa. And I know it's supposed to be cute, but Daisuke's obsession with this girl is freaking creepy. I mean, the guy keeps a 3-foot painting of her in his bedroom. Stalker, much? Well, anyway, on the evening of his 14th birthday, Daisuke is looking at his creepy stalker painting when his body freakishly mutates into that of a different person. It turns out that the reason his mom and grandpa had been training him in martial arts his whole life was so that on the day he turned 14, he could assume the identity of a legendary Phantom Thief named Dark, whose DNA has been stored in their family's bloodline for centuries. And just to clarify before anyone gets confused, Dark is not an alter ego like with Superman and Clark Kent. He's a totally different person who shares the same body as Daisuke. Well, Dark's purpose is to steal cursed artifacts so that Daisuke's family can purify them before they cause any serious harm. Also, in a really unique and bizarre twist, it turns out that Daisuke's transformations into Dark are controlled by him seeing images of Risa. I won't even question how that's supposed to work because it means Daisuke will have trouble stalking her, which I have no problem with. And speaking of Risa, after she sees Dark on the television, she falls madly in love with him. Of course, totally unaware that he shares the same body as Daisuke. So what we end up with is a really clever and interesting love triangle where Daisuke's in love with Risa, but Risa's unknowingly in love with Daisuke's alternate personality. This was actually one of the major draws of the anime to me, and it kept me interested even when there wasn't a whole lot going on in terms of action. But now let's talk about the characters. I've already mentioned this in a top 10 video, but I really don't like Daisuke. Stereotypical, love-struck, adolescent boy characters have a tendency to really get on my nerves, and Daisuke is the prime example of such a character. Although, I will give the anime credit. Unlike Ku from Elemental Gelade, they don't deliberately overplay his character for cheap laughs. Also, I do kinda like how he's not totally helpless without Dark's power and can fend for himself if he needs to, so he's not horrible. But by far the greatest character in this anime is Dark. There's just something about this guy that awakens the fifth grader in me. He flies in on black wings, outsmarting the police with his superior stealth. He uses black magic to outwit his enemies and take his treasure, all for a cause he knows is righteous. Though I will admit, as awesome as Dark is, I don't consider him one of my all-time favorite anime characters because there's really not a lot of depth to him. With characters like Lelouch and Kazuma, you not only admire them, but can also identify with them because of what they've gone through. Dark is more of an Indiana Jones-type character. He's awesome, but that's about it. But this doesn't make him bad by any means. He's still my favorite character in the show, and I found that most people agree. Dark also has a familiar to help him out, a rabbit named Whiff. Honestly, I have sort of mixed feelings toward this thing. On one hand, it's pretty obvious the only reason he's there was so that they could have a cute rabbit in the show. The idea is that Whiff can transform to form Dark's black wings, but as long as there's already magic in this anime, wouldn't it have just been easier to have Dark have the wings whenever he transformed? Dark's already a supernatural character. You don't need a rabbit for this plot point to work. But on the other hand, Whiff is cute, I guess, and he's not really hurting anything by being in the show. I guess I'm just bitter that they felt the need to dedicate a whole episode to Whiff falling in love with a female rabbit. I don't care how cute that is, it's stupid as hell and has no place whatsoever in an action anime. Now let's talk about Risa. The general consensus is that she is by far the worst character in the anime, and I can kinda see why. She's a total fangirl who's obsessed with Dark and goes to ridiculous lengths to try and meet him. And when she does meet him, all she ends up doing is getting in his way. So, is it bad to say that I kind of like her? Okay, she's not a great character by any stretch of imagination. But I do really like how she's able to see the good in Dark when everyone around her is skeptical and fearful of him. And since we, the audience, know that Dark's really a good guy like she believes him to be, it made me feel that at least her heart was in the right place, even if she did come off like an annoying third wheel at times. Also, even though she's totally clueless about Daisuke's feelings toward her, she's still a very kind and cheerful person, so it's believable that he would like her. But the criticisms against Risa are fair, and I fully understand that I'm a total minority on this. Another character to talk about is Risa's fraternal twin sister, Riku. Riku is a great character. In fact, probably the most complex and realistic out of the whole cast. She's the polar opposite of her twin sister. Where Risa's kind and carefree, Riku's a total tomboy. But this isn't the dominating factor in her personality. She does have her emotional soft spots, and it's really friendly with Daisuke. Actually, one thing in particular that's really great about Riku is that she likes Daisuke probably more than Risa, but can't stand Dark. That's both clever and hilariously ironic. So that's the main character cast of D.N.Angel. I could go on and talk about some of the other side characters and the villain, but I just wanted to give a basic overview. Overall though, this is a really great character cast. Every character is unique, and even the minor characters stick with you after the anime is over. The story, on the other hand, is more of a mixed blessing. Most anime take a very serial-like approach to the story in that every episode transitions into the next. D.N.Angel's story is very non-linear. Most of the episodes have a clear beginning, middle, and end, much like most American cartoons. And that's fine, although you could make the argument that it makes the anime a lot less addictive. But there's a lot of episodes that just seem like boring, pointless filler. I'm not even sure it's possible to have filler in a non-linear story, but this anime somehow found a way. For example, there's an episode about Dark concocting an elaborate scheme to get a birthday present for Daisuke's mother. And there's also an episode where Risa and Riku put on disguises and switch places for a day. I'm sorry, I was promised a badass Phantom Thief in this anime. Where's the goddamn Phantom Thief? Then again, I shouldn't be that harsh on it. I mean, D.N.Angel is just as much about the relationships with the characters as the action. But even so, it does have a tendency to drag. But it's worth noting that the vast majority of the episodes are not like this. And it gets really exciting the closer you get to the end. So that's D.N.Angel. Like I said, it's no masterpiece, but I don't really think it's supposed to be. It's a fun shonen action anime with some great gothic designs and is really exciting when it wants to be. The characters are memorable, and the relationships between the characters are really engaging and surprisingly complex. Yes, it does have its problems, but so does everything else out there. If you're looking for something dark, serious, and psychological, you should probably look elsewhere. But if you just want to enjoy watching an anime, D.N.Angel's a great choice to check out. It was among the first anime I ever saw, and it still sticks with me even today, so give it a watch. As always, this is ShadowACS, and I'll see you next time.